it happens. But if the patient is a pre-eclampsia, eclampsia or something happening and you are doing a cesarean, something happens, but this is a fetal death. What district collector told is absolutely correct. Because if you attend the case, talk to the relatives. I feel if you, I give a small example which has happened. My mother had gallstone. We'll examine some blood test to my mother. And I told the anesthetist, I like to operate mother. Who is operating? I am operating. How can you operate your mother? I told him, any elderly lady coming to me as a patient, I say is my mother. I operate her as my mother. And this is another patient, why can I not operate? He said, are you really serious? Yes sir, I will operate. If somebody else got the CVD, who will do? So I operated her and then took her home at 4 o'clock. I managed at home. Few days later, the anesthetist's daughter got acute appendicitis. Abhi, who will give anesthesia? He says, no, I'll give anesthesia. Somebody else will something. Okay, so he operated. So plus minus cancelled. So this thing happens, and what message I want to convey, please consider he's one of a relation, the patient. If you feel he's your sister or mother or brother or father, you will never neglect them. And if you never neglect them, this, all the situation, the theme of the thing will never come off. I want to convey this message to all my doctor's colleague. Anybody coming to the hospital, they are coming in trouble time. They are having a trouble time. Do not increase their trouble. Try to help them maximum. And if you ever trouble, he's there to trouble you further. So if you do like this, I think you will have to delay cesarean section, tubectomy failure, bowel injury due to tubectomy. I managed many few cases. And one case bowel injury, and ladies, multiparous ladies, flabby abdomen, you get the signs very late. And the gynecologist during laparoscopic tubectomy, trocar went into the bowel. I told patient lady require a laparoscopy. No, I have done very well. You have done very well, I agree. Knowingly, nobody does a mistake in surgery. But unless you do, then she is asking, can you do a small incision? Yes, we'll try small incision. My policy is, incision cannot be decreased, it can be increased only. So start with a small incision, and if it is requiring, increase. So you try the small incision, located the bowel injury, put the sutures, but when you are cleaning the abdomen, you look a little bigger incision. So extended on 3-4 centimeter incision and then cleaned up, the lady went up well. Later on, the gynecologist told me, I think you are correct, Pujari. Yes. I usually tell truth. I don't tell lie. Complications in surgery. The one of the previous presenter has told one hospital, Apollo Hospital. Actually, that was a Whipple's operation. And they've already spent 24 lakhs. How I got appointment to Apollo, but I had already joined one college, so that's why, because you cannot keep shifting. So they told this is happening. I told if something has happened, you will have to deal with that. And they gave me identity card, everything. Then I refused to join them. So this is a must. Litigation following bowel injury. There are so many litigation, you can see anything. But in bowel injury, if you detect it early, during surgery or immediate or post-op, only thing is if you are in a denial mood, you are killing somebody. So denial mood should not be there. Take a second opinion, third opinion, take a consensus. And bowel injury, earlier there is no conservative management in bowel injury. It has to be. The key word in bowel injury is source control. You must control the source, then do the toileting, then it is relatively safer. However, in colonic injury, it has to be done at the earliest. If it is more than 72 hours, this person not likely to survive. Everybody must remember the Amitabh Bachchan story. He had a colonic injury. He kept the wound open, laparostoma, and doing washing, so much of new antibiotics were flown in from for him. He survived. But colonic injury, very difficult. Gynecological surgery, this is, I've already told what are the points in which the litigation takes place. One is fatality, bowel injury, maternal death, and child death. And here, again, same thing. What district collector also told, if you come, nobody will be there. Actually, if you see, my thinking policy is, your casualty is the face of your hospital. If the casualty, most of the film actors, what do the face? They make up the face. Spend so much of money. Our hospital, unless we spend little money and equip the casualty, the face will not be distorted. And then, lot of litigation can be avoided. How to avoid? One, good communication with the patient and their relatives. Every time you visit the patient, minimum all surgeons, I see at least twice, morning and evening. So as soon as they finish, go and talk to them. Their patient is like this. And one of the important things, there are a few surgeons available here. Any surgery you finish, come back with your gloves and gown and tell them the surgery is over. Because unless you realize how tense they are, as soon as you finish the surgery, I do a practice. Only problem here is Telugu Kuncha.
Yes,
thank you, sir. Thank you. So I call one of my PG and tell them, you tell that surgery is over, person is all right. That's all they want to hear. And most of us, what to do, surgery over, have a cup of tea first. Cup of tea can wait. But meeting the patient's relatives must be fast. Am I telling truth? WHO surgical checklist. At least the side changes, left side operation, right side doing surgery, can be avoided by surgical checklist. We have started in our hospital, but you know, initiatives is somebody else. But continuation, other people should join in. And if somebody has initiated this process, because he is not there, we will not do. This is the problem here. So we'll try our best to continue. Consent of the disease, various therapeutic options. What I do, I am telling you. I am a GI fellow. So I call all the available relatives. I tell them what is the disease, what is the surgery. This person will cut, this person will join. There are big vessels, it might be bleeding. And at the end of pre-op note, I write down, explain to the relatives, I tell the relatives, all the relatives have to sign. If you all, everybody is intimated and they have signed in their consent form, and the case sheet also, I write down. Then, every time you meet the patient, see the patient, meet them, chances are very remote. Still some thought fellow will come and instigate them, that's a different issue, but unlikely. Good documentation. What is happening if you go to NABS accredited hospital? What they do right, the name particular of the patient, date and time what you have signed is seen, and write out your note and give a signature. At times, if necessary, call one of the relatives, come and see, he's doing well, get a signature from him. These are the way possibly we can avoid. This is the WHO checklist, surgical checklist. Use these three phases before, once the patient goes in, before incision and before leaving the operation room. This is designed by one of our Indian, Dr. Govande in the US. He's a Marathi doctor. He is a surgeon, but he is now doing writing, medical writing. And let us honor these few people, those who have done some work. We are losing nothing. Another thing, the anesthesia, pre-anesthesia checkup checklist that's also coming up. I request our HOD anesthesia, so let us join up together and do this process. So our, at least we can make them happy. If you see a smile on the face of a patient and their relatives, I think we have got the prize. Thank you very much. So far I have not neglected anything.